city of brotherly love to the city that never sleeps. It's day two of the Universal Open Rocket League live from the heart of New York City. Live streaming on Twitch and the NBC Sports app, it's the Northeast Regional. And if today is anything like the East Regional yesterday in Philadelphia, you are in for quite a treat. All right, everyone, and welcome to the SNY studios here at 4 World Trade Center. I'm your host, Kevin Naki, and we are going to go through day two of the Universal Open Rocket League here at the Northeast Regionals in New York City. Now, of course, to take me through all of the action here, I've got my two very wonderful friends and casters. It is, of course, Mr. Quentin Lobdell and Corelli. How are you guys doing today?
Doing great. Awesome to be here.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've got so much to go over from what happened in the competition yesterday to roll us through exactly what is going to be happening today as well. So we started things off with 8 qualifiers through the middle of July. Over 2,300 teams entered into the competition. 40 teams advanced to the regionals. We've been holding the regionals now. The U.S. Open has already finished. 4 teams advancing to the grand finals there. Yesterday, we cleaned up the East region as well. And today, we're going through the Northeast. Later on in the month, we're going to have the European Invitational, and everything ends up at the grand finals in Santa Ana. Now, it's important to note, these are 2v2 matchups through the Universal Open. This is different than the traditional 3v3 competitive format, and it resulted in some fireworks yesterday. We are, of course, playing soccer, and we're going to be playing on DFH Stadium. So, currently, overtime rules, so you know, golden goal wins. So here's your bracket for today. In the quarterfinals, with best of threes, you have Cloud9 versus Brotherhood to kick things off, LCG versus Trash Cans, Onslaught versus ABN Gaming, and Ambition Esports versus Goomba Squad. Keeping up the day. And the fourth, let's send it over to the fourth member of our broadcast team, Larry Ridley, who's in the bullpen right now. Larry, take it away.
Hey, Kevin, from Studio 31 here to Studio 41. This is the Met Studio here for World Trade Center for the SNY Studios. And this is the bullpen area, apropos, right, since we're talking about the bullpen and the Mets. And you can see we got the guys warming up here. You've got AVN. You've got... Also, you got Goomba Squad. We got 43. Donnie, you got 43. You left 43 girls at home today to come concentrate on Rocket League. Donnie, we got Zephyr. We got Kobe. You guys ready to go? Guys are labbing. Hey, they come in here, guys, to warm up and get ready. They usually spend about, I'm told, about 30 minutes to a couple of hours warming up. They don't like to go into these games cold and before they get into the Rocket League Championship. So it's all about the Universal Open. These guys are getting ready. And the Northeast Regional will start right here in the SNY Studios, guys. It should be a well of a time and a fun afternoon and into the evening here live on SNY at 8 o'clock, guys. So let's go back to you, Kevin. I'll see you throughout the course of the day, buddy.
All right, guys. Well, let's get through a little bit of what happened yesterday in Philadelphia. Of course, it was day one of the action. And Corelli, Quinn, I got to bring you guys in on this one. We found out that G2A and G2B both qualified for the grand finals. Is that what we expected? Were there any big surprises? What did you guys see from yesterday?
I mean, it was definitely G2's day, to be sure. Both teams having a great, fantastic performance all throughout the day. There were some big upsets, I would say, in the fact that we did get to miss out on JNabs and Dad. We had a couple substitutes. It was a big surprise, but everything worked as expected. I predicted G2A and G2B to make it all the way through that bracket, went just as I thought.
Fair enough. Corelli, same thoughts for you?
I absolutely agree. I think G2A and G2B were the teams to win here in Philadelphia, and they did. You say no surprises, but we had a ton of surprises during that broadcast. A ton of things happened that was really unexpected, but made it a good broadcast in the end. So I'm excited to see G2A and G2B move on to Santa Ana.
True. I guess Dad Sleeps On stuff is certainly a story. Things did certainly happen yesterday, even if he maybe didn't bring the best A-game performance to that match against G2A. So obviously, big question on my mind, though, was what was 2v2 going to look like? How were these amateur 2v2 teams going to compete against the big pros? So, Corelli, let's start with you on this one. What did you see from these amateur 2v2 guys? Any glimmer of hope for them today?
Today? Yeah, I think so. I think there's a little bit of glimmer of hope. I think the competition today is a little bit stronger than it was in Philadelphia, so it's going to be a little bit harder. But I think overall the teams here are a little bit higher quality, and I think they have a chance here today.
All right. Well, let's go ahead and move into the brackets here. As you guys could see from yesterday, we're going to go over now to Larry, who's actually standing by with Cloud9 as they prepare to go into their first quarterfinal match. Larry, take it away.
All right, joined now by Cloud9, we have Squishy over here, and we got Torment right here. We'll start with you, Torment. This team that you're facing right now, Brotherhood, you said it's probably the toughest matchup that you guys might face in this tournament. Talk about the difficulties going up against these guys.
They're a really solid team.
We just have to make sure we play our A game, and we'll definitely be able to keep up and hopefully win the match. They're a really good team, though, and they're really high-level players and probably our toughest competition. So,
Squishy, just talk about the challenge that Brotherhood poses to you guys.
We just have to stay level-headed and play at our best of our potential and really try our best to stay focused and just make sure we do whatever we can to play solid.
All right, you guys are the favorites. All eyes will be on you. See if you guys can do what you said you were going to do, which is guard against being overconfident. Guys, Cloud9.
Okay, so Cloud9, this is a team that's just been recently picked up by the organization. I don't want to say they've come out of nowhere, but boy, have they exploded recently. We're not supposed to pick favorites or anything like that at this stage, but you guys are giving me some indications that you guys are pretty good, maybe favorites to win the whole thing. Talk to me about them.
Yeah, I definitely think that Cloud9 is going to be the favorites coming to this tournament, and for good reason. They have two of the strongest North American players in the game. I mean, Squishy Muffins is a monster. The guy has thousands and thousands and thousands of hours. He practices so hard. He's a great worker, dedicated player. And I mean, you watch the guy, you will see his mechanics, his skill. It's so easy to see, and it's a great player to watch in the eyes. I think they're going to do great.
Is this as open and shut for you? Is Cloud9 the team to beat here?
Yes, they're the team to beat. In this next matchup, though, I think it's going to be very, very close. All four of these players are extremely high-level players. Cloud9, they've been feeling themselves lately. They're a high-level team. They've been doing well at, you know, DreamHack, whatever. Great team. But you look at Firebird and Moses, proven players in the scene. This is 2v2. It's going to be tough for Cloud9 to take them down.
All right. Well, speaking of Team Brotherhood, Larry is standing by with them at the moment. So, Larry, let's hear what the players have to say.
All right, we have Brotherhood here, and we've got Fireburner and also Moses. And we're going to start with you, Fireburner. You're known as one of the top goal scorers in all of Rocket League. You were awarded that top prize and top award in RLCS. What are you going to do with that?
Well, usually most of my goals just come off of positioning. So I'm going to try to do that here with Moses in 2v2, just try to capitalize off their mistakes and hopefully put the ball in the net.
Moses, you talk about it going up against Cloud9, toughest opponent that you guys will face, probably the top two teams. How confident are you heading into this matchup with Cloud9?
Pretty confident. I mean, it's 2v2. We're mostly like all focused on 3v3, so should play a game, hopefully come out with a win.
Should have been an interesting quarterfinal, guys. Got Brotherhood here against Cloud9. Back to you.
All right, so now we got to talk Brotherhood. This is an interesting team to me. They're going up against who we think are the favorites of the tournament, the number one qualifier from the New York region. These are the number four qualifiers from New England, but they seem like they're playing a lot better level than that. What's going on with these guys?
Right, there was a bit of an upset during the qualifier. They lost to a team that many expected them to just absolutely shut out. We saw Prime Thunder, and I believe it's Pepiopi as his teammate. I mean, it's incredible to see how much of an impact it's going to have on them. And as a result, instead of going in as the second seed, where they were expected to be, they're going to be going in as the fourth seed, and that's going to have them playing Cloud9 in the first match.
Yeah, when you look at this team right now, you have Fireburner from NRG, Moses from Renegade. Fireburner is a three-time NA online champion in the 3v3 world. He is big time here, and he's going against a team that's hot right now. So, yin-yang here. It's hard to tell.
All right, well, let's see who's actually going to win. It's time now for our game. The first quarterfinal of the day, best 2 out of 3 between Cloud9 and Brotherhood. Let's go ahead and get the game started.
Do have Cloud9 going against a Brotherhood. Like you said, C9 Squishy, C9 Torment on fire lately here in the Rocket League world. But can they do it now in the 3v3 world? This one kicks off towards the C9 half. Fireburner fires off a shot. Top post there, it's Torment on the clear. Moses in pursuit, Torment, the far clear again from him. Fireburner there to contest, and Squishy plays this one towards net. Moses, good control from him, bringing this up and down, and that's what you want to do in 2v2, bring the ball down, find the space, take on your 1v1 opportunities.
Yeah, I totally agree with that, Corelli. The worst thing that you can do in 2v2 is to waste your boost by going for aerials that you don't need to go for. Keep the ball on the ground, use dribbles. You want to maintain possession of the ball, and that's the best way to do it. Hitting the ball to the other side of the field is not a great tactic in 2v2. It's going to invite a lot of pressure.
Moses there. The shot's actually going to end up in the middle of the field here. Fireburner trying to knock it down. He almost does again. The second effort from him doesn't connect. Moses fires off a shot. Now it actually goes in.
Incredible shot there from Moses. I mean, the pressure they're putting on Cloud9 was immense. It started off with a great touch from Fireburner, and Squishy unable to clear the ball. Moses recognizing where Squishy was going to place it, just not hard enough. Moses was able to just prey on that ball and put that in the net.
And when you talk about this Brotherhood team, two players that are very, very consistent in their own right, Moses and Fireburner, have been strong, strong defenders and strong attackers in the 3v3 world. Can they pull it off here in 2v2?
I think so. 2v2, primarily a more defensively oriented game mode. And the reason for that is because of the ability for other teams to just capitalize on their mistakes and easily score goals. So you want players, you want teams who are just going to be a little bit more relaxed, calm, level-headed, and not ones who are going to be reckless. And that's both Moses and Fireburner in a nutshell.
And then on the other side, C9 is such a scary team. These guys coming off the walls from any direction, such a fast team and mechanically skilled at the same time. They're putting on the pressure here against the Brotherhood. Moses gets deleted by Torment there as Squishy. You see Torment looking for the pass. He is there to receive it. Moses read that one perfectly though. As this ball just floats into the C9 corner. Squishy trying to play it out here. Fireburner meets him at that. Moses trying to bring it down, slowing down the play. Doesn't work as Squishy dunks it away. With a 1-0 lead, Brotherhood now feeling a little bit more confident against this hot C9 team.
Right, doing a great job wasting actually a lot of C9's time. It's really difficult for them to kind of set up any attacks. We haven't seen as many lateral passes as we would have liked to. Lateral passes are really a big key in 2v2. It lets you shoot from so much further, and in Rocket League, it lets you get a lot more speed and pace on the ball, making your shots that much more difficult to defend.
Here comes Moses for the Brotherhood. Torment clears that one away, almost halftime here. Brotherhood still up 1-0 here. C9's had a bit of a slow start here, but nothing to worry about yet. This is a best of three here. Squishy in his own corner on the dribble. He's dangerous here, known for his 1v1 play, known for his mechanical play. You let Squishy have space, he'll take advantage.
Right, and especially, I want to mention the fact that we're in a single elimination tournament. It's a huge point to bring up Squishy. He's so demoralizing playing against this guy. But if you see, he makes very few missed touches. Every time he misses the ball, you can almost guarantee he did that on purpose.
Torment off his back wall here, trying to find Squishy. He's there to receive it. Is he going to connect? He does pass Moses. Fireburner trying to dunk Squishy across. It doesn't happen, though, as Torment now into the Brotherhood corner. Moses now the clear from him, and C9 quick to scramble back here as the Brotherhood puts on some pressure. It's Torment. Good clear from him, and Squishy the flick on. Minute 45 left for both these teams as actually a pretty low scoring game. I'm surprised that that's actually happening here.
I mean, I want to say I'm surprised, but at the same time, when you think about who is playing in this game right now, we're talking about two players on the Brotherhood, Moses and Fireburner, both famous for their defense. I mean, Fireburner, we look at him, he's a top scorer in the RLCS. Larry mentioned that in his interview. And the reason why is because he's so defensive. As the third man in RLCS, he's usually the one who also comes in and scores the goals as the last man coming out.
Moses gets past one, and he actually puts it away. Moses carrying the Brotherhood right now.
Yeah, actually a bit of a misplay there from Torment. He didn't get the flick he wanted to. He wanted to get a little bit more height, and a great flick there off of Squishy. He didn't expect Moses to come so fast at the goal like that, and he was able to catch him off guard for another goal. I think we're really gonna have to see Cloud9 go for some demo plays, some bumps, a little bit more gimmicky play, and play a little grittier if they want to make something happen here. They only have a minute left.
I like that you say gimmicky, as that is the name of their third in the 3v3 C9 team gimmick.
It's just a coincidence, I swear.
Well, here they come, C9, trying to put on the pressure here. A minute left for them. It's Torment in the Brotherhood corner. Plays that one across. Squishy is there, but he's rotating out for boost. Here comes Fireburner on the other way. Stopped up by Squishy. Now brings this one down. Trying to take on Moses 1v1. Makes him turn back, and he beats him every single time.
Oh, this is so dangerous for Moses. This is where Squishy excels. Look, he turns, catches the ball, puts it into space. Moses is not close enough to be able to contest it, and he comes out just far enough, making the mistake thinking he could pressure the ball, and it puts him in no man's land. That's where you're unable to attack the ball, and you're also unable to defend your net.
And that's the threat from Squishy. You see him bring down that ball, and it makes you think. And you saw Moses, he creeped up, and then he turned back around, and Squishy punished him for that.
Right, Squishy just, what a great capitalization on Moses' mistake there. It's such a small detail, just that little bit of inching forward. But Squishy, he's just a maestro. I mean, he recognizes those opportunities.
Uh-oh, and Squishy's got another chance, and he does just tap it in. 2-2.
I told you, Corelli, this guy does not miss the ball. He's crazy. The best part here was the passive from Torment, rushing up to the wall, and Squishy able to get above Fireburner. That was the key play there. Just great positioning from Squishy, and a wonderful pass from Torment. Lets them tie the game up in just under a minute, like 45 seconds, I believe. It's crazy.
First game of the day, starting off with a bang. two-goal deficit, and now we're all tied up with the last 15 seconds ticking down. C9 maybe trying to finish it out here. No, Torment opts not to go for this one. Here comes the Brotherhood now on the other side. Moses beats one. Fireburner there to follow. No, he played patiently, and now Torment,
no.
He's got a breakaway. It's wide open for Torment. He puts it away with 30 seconds left.
The Brotherhood, how heartbreaking must this be for them? Squishy, he waits for the ball to reach the back of his car. It lets him get a lot of power, and Torment, he recognized it. You see, he waited behind both the defenders, and neither the defenders with the presence of mind to watch and look out for Torment. They didn't see where he was going.
3 seconds left for the Brotherhood. Can they do it? This is a good kickoff for him. Fireburner's got an opportunity here, but it's going to be a little light. Oh, Torment scared me there for a second, but he does get the save in the end. Cloud9 taking game one.
What a crazy storyline just for this first game. I mean, seeing Squishy and Torment make that two-goal comeback, nobody expected these guys to go down first in the game. I mean, Kevin, weigh in on this. What do you think about this match?
Am I wrong? It seemed like Brotherhood maybe got, I don't want to say lucky at the beginning, but they got in a couple of goals. You didn't expect them to get a little bit cheap, and it's like Cloud9 just kind of gave him 3 minutes a head start to be like, okay, hold on, we'll make it actually difficult now.
I'll say this, C9, it seemed like they were a little bit tired. Mm-hmm. It came out a little bit slow, and then all of a sudden the wheels started going, the gears started turning, and it's like, okay, the big machine's up and running now, and then you saw right. 20 seconds left, they make the comeback, and this is what they do.
Yeah, fair enough. So what you expected from them? Any surprises you see so far here?
My only surprise is the fact that Brotherhood were able to go up 2 goals that early. I didn't expect Cloud9 to be so lethargic, so slow. That's not what you want when you come to 2v2. Momentum is so heavily, it's just so important, the impact it has on this game. It's a single elimination tournament, and it's a best of three. There's not many chances. You lose one game, and you're on your last legs, backs up against the wall. It's a scary position to be in.
All right, well, if we're going by their average goal rate over the last minute, expect about 17 goals this match, something like that. So that's what I'm prepping for. Looks like we're about to move into game number two, though. So let's just get quick predictions. Do you think that Cloud9's going to let this one go? I mean, is there any way that Brotherhood refines themselves?
I think, like I said before, I think that C9 is up and awake now. I think they might just take this one over. Not to say anything about Brotherhood, but I think C9's awake now. They're ready to play. And this is I don't know how this one's going to go, but I think C9 might just take it.
I would agree. I think C9 smells their dinner and they're ready to eat.
All right. Well, we're about to jump into game number two here. As Quinn mentioned before, though, of course, this is single elimination, which means that if any of these teams lose, they are out of the entire event. Now, if you guys are curious what we're doing today, though, of course, we have these four quarterfinals to begin things off. We'll move into the semifinals next, which are going to be best of fives, and then whoever wins those is guaranteed a spot in the grand finals. But it looks like the game has loaded up. We're ready to go. Take it away, gentlemen.
Game number two, C9 against the Brotherhood here. C9 finally awake, ready to play as the Brotherhood now trying to bite back. After giving up a 2-0 lead and dropping his first game, Moses, the star for Brotherhood from last game, scoring 2 goals. It's Torment now on the clear, looking for Squishy. He's not there. Fireburner clears this one out to his own corner. Squishy keeping the pressure, comes right back down to him. Moses makes the save there, and Torment trying to keep this play alive. The rotations for C9 so good right now.
This pressure is relentless. We see Fireburner trying to get out of his own half, and Squishy does not let him. You'll see Torment and Squishy taking turns to move back, get some more boost, reposition themselves, and then just keep piling the pressure on the Brotherhood.
Oh, Fireburner almost getting the dunk there, but C9 lucks out now. Torment on the clear. Moses, good rotation from them to come back in. Misses the touch for them, and Fireburner patiently waiting for Squishy's play. He goes right past the ball. Here comes Squishy again. No, it's Moses on the clear. 100 boost for him now. He does get the dunk. Can he turn back around? No, it's Squishy off his own crossbar here to clear. The Brotherhood attempting to put on an attack here, putting on the pressure for C9 as they're both up and back on their back wall. Fireburner playing this one across. Moses in the midfield. He's there. He's going up for it. Not able to connect, and Torment, C9, breaking out of their own end now.
Oh, a great touch here from Fireburner to save a goal. I mean, that would be huge right there. It looked like C9 were on the breakaway, and they're just so calm and level-headed, and I think that's the biggest difference between these two teams. We see how methodical Cloud9 is playing in comparison to this Brotherhood team. He's no slouch either.
Uh-oh, Fireburner actually gets it past him as he just gets the flick off the dribble, and it rolls all the way across the field.
I'm dumbfounded. What just happened here? Cloud9, oh, Torment. What he tried to do was to get a bounce on the ball, and as the ball's lifting up off the ground, he wants to get another flip on the ball. That's going to give it a lot of power and height. Unfortunately, the timing let him kind of hit it softly and just pass it, put it on a platter for the Brotherhood.
But the Brotherhood find themselves up 1-0 here. 3 minutes and 15 seconds left. More than enough time for C9 to make a comeback. As we saw in the last game, they only needed about 15. There comes the pressure from then. squishy. Playing this one across, going for a second time.
Oh, the ceiling! Oh, what a shot! Squishy, are you crazy? This was incredible. Look, he brings the ball up off the side of the wall, and he lands on purpose. The reason he lands on that ceiling, I've mentioned it before in the last qualifier, the ceiling lets you maintain your flip for as long as you want. You have 1.5 seconds. By landing on the ceiling and falling, instead of jumping, he can keep that flip. The defender has no idea when Squishy's going to be shooting on the net. What an incredible display of mechanical skill from Squishy.
And that's what you expect from Squishy, and that's what makes him so dangerous, so consistent with it, too. It's such a dangerous thing that he has in his arsenal out of all the things that he has. But now for the Brotherhood, they got to shake it off. They got to come back in this one. That's a fantastic shot by Squishy, but the game is still tied up here.
And the score line is 1-1, but I guarantee you the Brotherhood's thinking, what do we do against that?
And there's nothing you can do. That's the thing about it. It's just so scary. But here comes the Brotherhood trying to fight back here. We're almost at halftime here. Squishy playing this one up and over. Fireburner, the big clear from him. A good clear at that. And he's able to follow it up himself, forcing Torment to just boom it down the field, opening up a bit of a tennis match here. As Moses actually almost gets a second touch. Fireburner gets dunked away by Squishy, and no one from the Brotherhood are on their side. Here comes T9, though. This ball just floating back to the midfield. Fireburner playing this one down towards net. Good shot, right? Forcing Squishy to make the save, at least.
Yeah, a lot of pace on that. Put so much pressure on Cloud9. Barely able to keep that one away and keep the scoreline level.
Moses trying to keep this play alive for them, but stopped up by Torment. Here's Fireburner moving this ball down. Squishy forced to retreat back now. Brotherhood trying to set up for something here. Here's Moses. Opt not to go for that one. Just rotates out, taking the C9 boost. Here comes Squishy, though. The shot from him. It's a long shot saved by Fireburner. Trying to play this one towards the middle now. Onto the air dribble. He does get the dunk on Torment. And if there's anything about Fireburner, it's that he doesn't lose 50-50s.
Oh, this guy is known as the king of 50-50s. Just to clarify for the viewers at home who may not be familiar, 50-50s when two players, just like we see right there, approach and challenge the ball at the same time. They call the 50-50 because no one knows who's going to win.
Fireburner, an expert at those, but Torment, shot goes off the crossbar there as Brotherhood now trying to play this one out. Moses trying to play that one across. Torment now on the clear. Fireburner waiting for the attack from C9. Does get the dunk on Torment. Squishy forced to go up here. Can Fireburner? No, he can't get it over. But here comes Moses. 45 seconds left on the clock here. The second touch from Moses. What a beautiful shot from him.
Incredible double touch. I mean, we are just seeing beautiful goal after beautiful goal. Look at this touch. He waits and holds his boost purposefully to save it. He wants to maintain his speed, and he doesn't want to move any faster. He wants to give the ball time to bounce off of their backboard and come back to meet him with enough distance to hit the ball downwards. Great play there from Moses. Impossible to defend.
C9 find themselves down here just by one goal with 30 seconds left. More than enough time to at least tie it back up, force an overtime. Here comes Squishy, and he does get it. No defense from the Brotherhood.
This is a huge mistake, I believe, from Moses. Look, Fireburner goes for this touch. He lands on the wall. Moses is nowhere to help Fireburner. He actually saved the ball, landed on the wall, and used that to be able to recover on the ground and tried to flip to save the ball a second time, but it's just too much for him to handle. He needs his teammate, and unfortunately, that's going to let Cloud9 tie up the game.
And just like last game, in under a minute, Cloud9 coming back. It's Torment. The long shot from him, and it's actually going to go through Squishy. No, he's not going to steal it. But it does go in for C9, and all of a sudden, they're in the lead.
Squishy there just going to back up his teammate. Torment recognizing that Moses is nowhere available to defend that. And we see Moses flipping. When you flip, you gain speed. And the reason why you'll see him flipping there and not using his boost is because he has none.
One goal lead for C9. 20 seconds left. Squishy on the dribble, flicking up and over Fireburner. He does get a piece of it. The Brotherhood's got to make something happen here, or they are out of the tournament. This is a best of three. Moses, no, he's not going to make the save.
Squishy, have mercy. Can you just have a bad game for once in your life? Look at this touch from Torment. Oh, that double touch pass, so incredible. It just, it makes it so difficult to defend when you see the car so close to the wall. It's hard to understand how the ball is going to move from the wall, and Squishy just great position to capitalize on Torment's monstrous pass.
And that could be it for the Brotherhood. Fireburner doesn't put away that goal. That could have been helpful there, but that's gonna be it. C9 is gonna take this one 2-0 over the Brotherhood.
And I believe that's gonna be it for the Brotherhood. This is a best of three, and just like that, we watched Cloud9 dismantle one of the favorites to actually make it to the Grand Finals over in Santa Ana. And it's just unbelievable. This is the skill we're talking about when we look at this Cloud9 team. We see them not just with set plays, but with the understanding between their teammates. Just a wonderful play between the two of these guys. Great, great series.
So does Cloud9 have a gentleman's agreement with everyone in this tournament to just not do anything until halftime? Like, is that their game plan, to handicap everyone about half the matches and then just go from there?
They might. I don't know. And I don't know why that happens. But, you know, yeah. Cloud9, they took a little bit of a while in each game to really kind of get going. But You can see the fantastic plays from Squishy. Expect so much more. He's going to be doing that all day long.
All right. So, let's draw a couple of conclusions from this. Obviously, sure. Once Cloud9 got going in both games, they looked like Cloud9, right? We were wondering maybe if it's in the first couple of minutes of the first game. Now these guys came to play. Mm-hmm. Are they in shape exactly like you thought they were? Are they missing a step right now? How good is this Cloud9 right now?
Well, let me give you some context for Cloud9. Cloud9 is actually formerly known as Muffin Men, and before that, Team Iris, where they had a third member, Lechino, and their team. I mean, these two guys have been playing together for so long, and you can see that on the field. I mean, there are a few mistakes. I think they took a little bit of time to get warmed up, maybe a little bit nervous. These are actually very young guys, but here you look. He delays his flip until he's underneath the ball, and that just catches just enough power on it. It's incredible. I mean, this Cloud9 team is here to play.
You want to talk about meta. The ceiling shots have really come into the meta lately. I don't know, maybe about the last 4, 5, 6 months. The ceiling shots are something that is so hard to defend, and no one knows how to defend them yet. As you see, just the long shots coming out from C9 there, and Squishy almost able to steal that one, but he doesn't in the end. And these teams were actually very close, and I'm surprised that the Brotherhood were actually giving up their leads.
Yeah, and during the first couple of minutes, it seemed like their defensive gameplay was really working out for them. That Cloud9 did nothing during the first half in both games, right? I mean, and then afterwards, something happened. The crack opened in the dam, and then all the water ran loose. What happened?
I'd say it's a bit of like an adaptation period. The Cloud9 are kind of playing slowly, and they're looking to see how their opponents want to approach this series. I mean, we mentioned it before, a single elimination, best of three. I was talking with the Brotherhood before this match, and they told me they were worried. They were really, really worried. And they played confident. Mm-hmm. But they knew the impact Cloud9 could have, and we watched Cloud9 playing it slowly, looking to see how they would approach this. And since Fireburner and Moses are both known as defensive players, Cloud9 let them kind of get out of their comfort zone and put the pressure on them. And once Cloud9 realized, we saw so many of those long goals coming from Cloud9, and it was a result of overextending, playing too much offense and not realizing how important it is to rotate back on defense, because that's not where they're best.
Right.
The Brotherhood, right? And Cloud9 seemed to have a great game plan, and it worked. It worked perfectly.
All right, guys. Well, let's go ahead and take a look at the updated brackets. As we know, Cloud9 moves past Brotherhood 2-0 to advance into the semifinals. And again, just to let you all know, whoever wins the semifinals makes it into the final. They are qualified for the grand finals in Santa Ana. So Cloud9, just one series away. And I do believe that Larry right now is standing by with our winners, Cloud9. So Larry, take it away.
Yeah, Kevin here in Studio 42, standing by with C9. And we're going to talk to Torment. And did the alarm clock not go off in your hotel room? You guys got off to a slow start. But talk about how huge it was getting those goals late in those games in both contests in game one and game two for you guys.
Yeah, we were feeling like pretty just slow. We weren't really like ready yet. Kind of warmed up like midway through the game, actually in both games. This man right here, he played insane. Big goal scorer. I got most of the easy goals. That's kind of my job. But, yeah, I'd say credit goes to him. Some of those goals were nuts.
Squishy, why were you guys so lethargic to begin the game?
I don't know. I think we're really nervous because the best of three and anything can happen. So we really wanted to make sure we got that first win. I think that was what was really affecting us the most, just the nerves, I guess, trying to get that first win.
Real quickly, looking ahead, you guys are going to the semifinals. Now, you said this was going to be the toughest game you guys will probably play here against Brotherhood. How confident do you feel now knowing if you guys play your A game, that's what you guys told me, right? You're going to be hard to stop, and you should win.
I think that was our biggest hurdle. I think this next game won't be an easy match, but I think it'll be easier. And, yeah, I think we could definitely take it and qualify.
All right. Good luck, guys. Moving on to the semifinals, Squishy and Torment from Cloud9. And we're going to have much more here from the Northeast Regionals. The Universal Open here at the SNY Studios in Four World Trade, including LCG coming up. Yes, we're twinning. The Twins will be playing, and they're going to be coming up next here when we come back with more of the Universal Open here in New York City, Manhattan, from the SNY Studios Four World Trade Center.